Hi guys, this is Mrs. Blackstock. I'm your 8th grade science teacher. In this video, we're just going to go over some do's and don'ts, some expectations. We're going to look at the syllabus and make sure that you understand how to contact me. I'm also going to give you instructions on how to help me get to know you. So sit tight.
So about me, really quickly, I am originally from Virginia. I have been in Texas, though, for the last 15 years via military. This is my 15th year in Killeen ISD. I am a graduate of North Carolina A&T State University, Greensboro, North Carolina, home of the greatest homecoming on earth. I also attended University of Texas at Arlington, so I have 2 master's degrees from there. My favorite things, I like scary movies, I like fruit, and I like orange Sour Patch Kids, only the orange ones. So I buy huge boxes of the individually wrapped ones, and I pull out the orange ones. I usually just give the others away. I'm a mom, I'm a wife, my family is originally from the Democratic Republic of the Congo. So there's that picture right there in the middle of the screen. All right, so this course is 8th grade science. So this year I am teaching STEM science as usual, but I also have general science as well. So if you see me in the hall and say, oh, that's one of the STEM teachers, you know, the crazy lady chasing you out in the hall with the fly swatter because you're running down the hall, that was me. Yeah, I have regular ed this year as well as my STEM students. So I'm excited about that. So how can you contact me? Well, you can contact me by email, kathy.blackstock@killeenisd.org. I'm also on Instagram as the Awkward Science Teacher. There you'll just see past student work or articles related to things that we are working on right now. I have a YouTube channel where most of our lesson videos will be. So I put out my whole lesson together as a video. I post it to YouTube and I put the link in Schoology. So in there, that way it's the video is not dependent on Schoology because Schoology can get overwhelmed. So if something happens, Schoology crashes, like, you know, we know it tends to do sometimes, I can still send you the YouTube link if all else fails. So you can actually watch the lesson if nothing else. Even if you can't get to the work part, you can at least see the lesson and not get behind there. You can also get with me on Remind. I'm asking you to, so you can get those reminders on when test dates are, or if you need to just ask me a quick question. Right now, I'm going to leave the Remind chat open. Usually, kids do pretty good about that. Every once in a while, I get a year where the kids kind of, not necessarily the kids, sometimes family members can abuse that. But I've had a pretty good luck for the last couple of years, so I'm going to leave that open for now. So if you need to get in touch with me, you can. That way, if it's real quick. I usually can get back pretty fast on that. Email's always going to be the best way to contact me, but never by Instagram. I will never respond to a message sent by Instagram. That is just there for supplemental work. There's articles, past student work, pictures, things like that are on there. I never respond to an Instagram direct message. So that's out. But Remind chat, email, even Schoology chat to some extent. Sometimes I'm slow with the Schoology chat. But email or Remind and you'll probably get me. So this class is pretty simple. You need a composition notebook. Really, whatever notebook you use, it doesn't matter this year. Usually I'm really strict about that, but it's I'm not going to be this year. just make sure that the notebook you have has at least 100 pages, because usually we end up around page 160, 170, just depends. So make sure you have a full notebook, 100-page notebook at a minimum. You also, of course, need a pen, pencil, something to write with, color pencils or crayons, and then your laptop or tablet so that you have schoology access. And I mean, clearly you're watching this on something, so you're good to go. Tutoring.
Teach me.
Tutoring for this class is available virtually via Zoom every Tuesday and Thursday from 3:30 to 4:15. Wednesday is also going to be offered because Wednesday is the school mandated science tutoring day. So each core subject has its own day, and science is on Wednesday. So I'll be available on Wednesday as well. But don't forget that you can always email me if you have questions, or use the Remind chat to ask questions or seek help in the class at any time, most any time.
So why didn't I flinch? Because the laws of science differ fundamentally from those of...
Grade 8 science is interdisciplinary in nature. The 8th grade science curriculum has a focus on earth and physical science. Students learn about atomic structure, the periodic table, chemical reactions, formulas, and equations. We will also study Newton's three laws of motion, seasons, tides, lunar phases, stars and galaxies, plate tectonic theory, weather, and environmental changes due to human activities. Our units of study include interdependence among organisms, global weather patterns.
What is that? That's because it's hot outside.
Components of the universe, investigating the sun, earth, and moon.
Dunzao, bunzao.
Force and motion, atoms in the periodic table, chemical formulas and reaction, and of course, if we get there, everybody's favorite, worth the wait. Your Texas Essential Knowledge and Skills can be found at the link below. Your textbook is the same iScience book you've used for 6th and 7th grade. You can access it the exact same way on the website if needed. In-person learners,
morning for you,
are expected to attend class daily. So if you are going to do synchronous learning, then you should be in that Zoom meeting every day. In class, you'll receive your instruction, assignments, and assessments. If a student is absent, they may log on to the online learning management system and receive the missed instruction and submit assignments. Virtual learners will remain at home and will engage in learning activities that are delivered through Schoology. Live teacher-led instruction and peer collaboration may be scheduled throughout the day to expand students' opportunities to engage with content and interact with teachers and classmates. Students are expected to log in to each course subject daily and complete the posted lesson and assignment. Failure to log in daily and complete the posted assignment in each course will result in the student being absent for the course. You may see the Virtual Learning Student and Parent Handbook for more detailed information. Assessments and grading.
I passed! Alright! I passed! I got a D-! I passed!
If you are in the general ed course, then your formatives count 45%, your summatives are 55%. If you are in the pre-AP, GT, or STEM course, you are graded at 40% formative, 60% summative. There's your semester grade determination, with your first 9 weeks averaging being 45%, second 9 weeks 45%, and your semester exams. There are two of those. They will be 10% of your entire grade. Each student will receive a minimum of 9 formative and 3 summative grades per 9 weeks. You will most likely have more grades than that, but that is the requirement for every course. Class expectations, be prepared, respectful, and do your best. We're not going too deep into that because you're eighth graders. You're not pre-K kids. You know how to behave at school. You know what you're supposed to do. And you know how you're supposed to do it. So whether you are a virtual learner or when the time comes you're in-class learner, you will come to class prepared. You will have the materials you need, especially in this climate where it's probably safest that you bring your own supplies and not have to borrow a pencil that's been touched by 30 other kids that day. So have your supplies. Be respectful whether you're virtual. In that Zoom class, you can't be removed for being disrespectful. So just do your best at all times. Be your best. Be the person you were raised to be. And it's all good. This is how we do it. This is how we do it. So how do we do our work? All assignments will originate in Schoology. While the links may take you to other sites, you will always navigate there using Schoology as your starting point. You're going to check into your course folders daily. New stuff will be there every day. Every school day, there will be new things in that folder. Beginning on Wednesday, your daily lesson or assignment should be done before coming to class. Coming to class meaning coming to your Zoom lesson, logging into Zoom. I record the daily lesson so that you can stop or rewind at your own pace as needed in order to complete your notes. During the Zoom class time, we can clear up misconceptions, we can ask and answer questions, check for understanding, and debrief as needed. I don't want to project the video during the Zoom lesson because some people write faster than others, some are slower, and I want you to have control over starting and stopping the lesson video. So you will click on that in Schoology on your own and get your notes and those things done. So we will have the class time for clarification. As we move later in the year, that's where you can view experiments or demonstrations being done. There's not a lot for this particular unit, but as this continues, then you'll do things like that there. But your actual work is self-paced, so you go in the folder, get the work you need, and knock that out. Right before a unit assessment, we will do a Zoom version of Quizlet Live or other similar apps to review for your test, and your participation is expected. Your notebooks will be turned in for a grade near the end of each unit, so the process will be explained thoroughly prior to submission, so don't skip the notebook work. It's not a lot, it's just to help you kind of grasp the material and help you retain it, and you do have to turn those notebooks in. So keep up with your IMB work. The first test date is September 1st, so you know this unit is pretty short, and it won't be long before you have to turn in the notebook. Shout out. So if you think you did really good on an IMB reflection, or you had a big revelation about a lesson, or you're doing something out there on your own, related to the lesson, please send me a pic. Send me a pic or some details so I can shout you out during the lesson video or during a Zoom meeting. Also, if you do not want your name revealed, just tell me and I can show off and shout out your beautiful work anonymously. If I see excellent work during the IMB check and want to show it, I will always ask permission to say your name or default to presenting it anonymously if I'm unable to contact you prior to posting the video. So what are you doing today? Today, you're going to go to Schoology, you're going to click first 9 weeks folder, week of August 17th. In that folder, it should look like this. Click day one. There is a syllabus acknowledgement, and you're going to complete that quiz and submit it. And then you're going to click on Flipgrid, the Getting to Know You activity. So once you get in Flipgrid, it tells you what you need to respond to or what the prompt is. You're going to complete the prompt and you're going to respond to a minimum of 3 other classmates. Once you've done those two things, you're done for me for the day. Tomorrow, make sure you have your notebook because you're going to start needing it tomorrow to do a second get to know me activity and to start getting set up to do your content. So we're going to actually start lessons on Wednesday. But you do have another foo-foo activity, as I call them, to get us started tomorrow. So tomorrow we'll get more into getting your notebook set up and what I expect to see from that. All right. Hope you understand and you're a little more at ease if you were nervous. And I will see you in tomorrow's Zoom, I hope. Bye.